I entered BVB with three other people whose names I don't remember. During the event, I noticed that it would be really easy to escape the event and fly outside with Game Mode 1, and so I did. I escaped the event using the old let the boat float up in some water and enter in it, then leave it again trick. Once I did that, I was free and on top of the glass. After that, I went away to have dinner and didn't come online until the next day. The next day, I decided to go online and found I was still in Game Mode 1. So, I did as every person would do and spawned my inventory full of diamonds. I showed this to everyone online and told them I had Game Mode 1. However, no one believed me. After that, I didn't really play and didn't use my Game Mode 1 powers, but a few days ago, I logged back on to still find myself having Game Mode 1. And since I couldn't go back to my own place anymore, because I was in the event world, I committed suicide by falling through the world, and then I got to my own place and could actually store shit in chests in Game Mode 1. This is how I got Game Mode 1. What you might want to know or confirm is that I did abuse it to some extent. And I do think I deserve a punishment, but no eternal ban. We are all familiar with SimPvP's strict no exploitation policy. This applies for all players equally. But what if someone makes an exploit known but is simply not believed? Well, this was the case for the player iQuint. After he escaped an event, BVB, with creative mode still on. The incident sparked a debate on the server forums about what the punishment, if there should be any, should be for him. After all, he did make it known that he had found this exploit. However, upon being not believed, he did go on to use it to his own gain, even giving diamonds that he spawned in using creative mode to Pippinger, who eventually ratted him out. Right after his initial banning in early August of 2014, he went to the forum and made the previously read post. Immediately afterwards, followed a strong debate with proponents on both sides, either in favor of showing him leniency or outright banning him for eternity. Instead of trying to address the issue at hand, which was iQuint's incident, many people attempted to compare the incident with iQuint with others in the server's past. For example, LoneSoldier55 compares it to his own incident with being jailed, in which he passed the world border. Morlock compared the event to when Wolfbitten used an exploit to see where diamonds were located underground. He also mentioned Tuffy9, who got Game Mode 1 and tried to hide a bunch of shit in chests, to quote him. Nothing was done about either except for a warning. Wolfbitten was pardoned, and Tuffy9 was simply warned. In spite of those precedents, the roles of SimPvP, if taken purely for what they mean, literally, would seem to imply that iQuint should be banned, if not permanently, for at least a year. Quote, well, it says here, SimPvP has a zero tolerance policy for use of hacks or abuse of glitches. I remember when Zestia put this into place after the predicament with Lone a while back. He got off because, to be fair, the stance on glitches wasn't clear. He fills his inventory with diamonds and does not notify an admin about the issue, or at least it's not mentioned in his post that he did. Sounds like a ban to me. It's rather silly that we would ban people for spamming first time, but not for using glitches, out quote, according to TL Redemption. In addition to these complicated precedents that were set before, this issue also involved the use of little-known game mechanics, such as the ability to teleport through transparent blocks. Were these game mechanics simply that, game mechanics? Or did these things count as glitches as well? Again, an extremely hard line to draw, because a lot of old farm designs and other machines in Minecraft did use unintended features that did seem to go against conventional wisdom of how things in the game should be done. Whereas, we would all agree that using the piston glowstone x-ray machine was a bannable offense and clearly an exploit. In spite of all this confusion, in the end, the admins decided that he would get 6 months of jail time in the jail of the server. Now, what was that based upon? I really can't tell you. You'll have to ask Might9 or Ucor if you can get a hold of him. I really don't know. I think it's just a combination of the fact that everybody was so undecided between a year ban, a 6 month ban, or a perm ban. No one could really tell, so a compromise had to be reached, and 6 months just seemed to make sense. However, I should mention, a few people brought up the facts that Tuffy9 and Miniwimmy both reportedly had game mode 1 accidentally at some point and reportedly abused it to certain extents. However, this was never verified, so we don't really even know if they did or did not do those things. It's just common knowledge that they did. Anyways, that's really the entire story of iQuint's brush with being jailed and his stumbling upon an exploitation of Game Mode 1, Creative Mode, at the time. And I have been Lord Pasta. I hope you've enjoyed, and I will see you next time. Goodbye. Just...